In other news, the Philippine Central Bank and several business groups believe the Philippines can still hit its growth target for 2022 if the Omicron variant is contained in the first quarter of the year. Warren de Guzman reports.
COVID-19 cases are still surging at a record-breaking pace, but that hasn't fazed the Filipino-Chinese business community nor the Philippine Central Bank. Henry Lim Bonleong, president of the Filipino-Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry Incorporated, says as long as the current surge is resolved quickly, growth will remain strong.
Our economic growth that I forecasted now, 6.5% to 7.5% for this year, still remains now. Of course, the Omicron virus has put a dampen effect on this one, but as I see and I feel the pulse of our members, organizations, so I think as long as it doesn't go beyond the first quarter, no, we can still achieve a respectable 6.5%. But if it goes beyond the first quarter, no, then maybe to amend.
Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno gave the same assessment at the inauguration of the Management Association of the Philippines 2022 board, assuring the Philippine business community that rising lending, adequate bank capital, and easing inflation all point to a steady economic recovery.
We will still hit our projected growth of 7 to 9%. So the variant, as it turned out, is mild and less lethal. And so we're early in the year, right? So we hope that the variant will be gone by maybe middle of February or at the latest March. So that gives us confidence that we will hit our growth target of 7 to 9% this year and 6 to 7% for the next 2 years.
Jokno says another reason for optimism is the buffer provided by gross international reserves, which hit $108.9 billion as of December, good for over 10 months' worth of imports of goods and payments of services, or 8.8 times the Philippines' short-term external debt, based on original maturity. On top of this, Jokno notes bank lending has picked up, which is a sign of improved confidence on the part of the lenders as well as the borrowers, with both sides feeling confident the loans won't end up as bad debt even as the pandemic rages on.
As of the week of December 23, 2021, the banking system allocated an average of 244.4 billion loans to micro, small, and medium enterprises. This is a substantial increase from the 8.7 billion in MSME loans reported in April 2020. Banks currently remain cautious, but project rather positive business outlook in the next 2 years.
Newly installed MAP President Alfredo Pascual, however, reiterates his organization's stand. If the current surge forces some form of return to tighter mobility restrictions, the economy will suffer. He says instead, the government should focus on enabling the economy to move beyond pre-pandemic levels of performance.
Why should we return to the old normal? The pandemic has proved to be an excellent mirror for humanity, for all of us, in highlighting the social and economic inequalities and systemic weaknesses that afflict our people. We must address the country's energy security, resolve foreign ownership restrictions in critical industries, and improve the ease of doing business, to name just a few imperatives.
Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.